think her thighs could have been a little thicker.
Hey, what's up, you guys? Sean Misprime here doing another Transformers figure review on the Transformers 4 Age of Extinction One Step Changer Lockdown. If you're trying to get your Transformers figures, you can't get them.
Big. Get your big badass toys at BigBadToyStore.com. Click the link in the description below.
So it says ages 5 and up right there. Cool picture of Lockdown right over there. There's your one step change, all right. And then there's the side of the packaging, other side of the packaging right over there. And then we get a very shiny looking robot mode on the back. I hope it actually is. All right, let's get to it and crack this thing open. So here's Lockdown out of the packaging. And I think this is a beautiful looking car. I always love Lamborghinis. Specifically, he is a Lamborghini Aventador LP704. I always liked Sideswipe back in the day. Sideswipe was always really cool. Seeing this Lamborghini, I think, is pretty awesome. Unfortunately, this toy doesn't really hold together too well. You know, get a little bit weird. Oh, okay, and then he just transformed by accident. So that's transformation. Boom, end of review. I'll catch you guys later. Peace. Okay, I'm just kidding. But anyway, I do think this looks very cool. It does roll very well. And like I said, it does have all these gaps all over the place. You don't want to hit that button or else he's going to transform on you. And as we take a closer look at it, I really like the color choice. It's almost like a brown metallic gray kind of color. It's kind of weird. I really like this color. It's just off. And I like the Decepticon logo we have right there. You have some blue for the headlights, silver right there for the front windshield. We have gaps right there for the side mirror, for the side windows anyway. This is much more of a regular gray. This has that, I don't know how to describe this, but it's like a tannish kind of gray color. I think it looks really cool. Again, I like the end right here, and we get another one of those little, I don't know, silver tail lights, kind of like how we had on Drift. And then we have this piece right over here, looking very nice with the blue. So yeah, you know, not too complex, but sculpted pretty well, and I like how it looks. You know, it's a pretty cool looking car. Unfortunately, it just doesn't stay in one solid piece the way I would like it to. Now, Lockdown measures out to be about 4.5 inches across. And here he is next to the one step changer Drift. And Drift looks quite a bit heftier than Lockdown over here. Kind of a little bit bigger. I guess they have about the same length going on, really. But yeah, so there you go. Much taller car mode anyway. Still think this guy looks a little better though. I like the, damn it, just piece together, damn you. So premature transformation aside, I'm still gonna ask Bumblebee for some help. Will you take us away, Bumblebee? Yeah, you know, they're not going to lay you off, Bumblebee, because of that. So here you go. You hit this button and boom, there it goes. So this whole piece lifts up over here and you have Lockdown. So there he is in his robot mode and he looks pretty cool. They did keep this silver paint consistent with how it looked on the back of the packaging. Doesn't run down through the legs over here. It's just on this upper torso and the head area. And I think it actually looks pretty cool. It's not a bad looking toy. The back of it, you can see it's just the Lamborghini again. But looking at it this way, it's not too bad. So the head sculpt came out very cool. We have the one eye of Lockdown coming through here. We're not getting the face sculpt on this one. Not a big deal. I think both look pretty nice. I really like the silver paint apps. Nice sculpting throughout though. This is just a kid's toy, but they did sculpt the hell out of it, and I think that is great. Can't see the back of his head, but that's sculpted pretty well too, even these little parts right here. So they didn't go cheap on the sculpting, and I really like that. And this torso section over here looks pretty awesome, so I can't dog that at all. And we have a little bit of blue in there too, change things up. And we have this flat gray plastic going in here that I'm not a big fan of. The hands look like they're sculpted pretty well. The thighs have some nice detail in them. And then it kind of just disappears from here on down and just turns into, I guess, like a car feet or something. I don't know. So for as far as articulation goes, Lockdown cannot move his head and he can't move his arms and he can't move his legs unless you're transforming him back into car mode. So that's really it, and that's how you transform him back into car mode. That really sucks. No articulation at all whatsoever, and this doesn't even hold that well together when you try it. But actually, this is incredibly frustrating right here, getting this to stay together as one piece. And there it goes. It's not actually too terrible. But Drift, he had arms that could, you know, move forward and out at least, and this just fell apart again. And Drift stands at about 5 inches tall. And here he is next to Drift, looking kind of tiny compared to Drift. Looks like Drift can kick his butt easily. And here he is next to the Marvel Legends Big Time Letdown Spider-Man. So I have to say, I'm terribly disappointed with this figure. I actually really just wanted to have the Lamborghini car mode to just roll around and play with. You know what I mean? And I thought it looked really cool. It was on sale at Target. Instead of it being 10 bucks, it was only like 7 something. So I thought, hey, you know what? It's the last Lockdown here. The shelves are full of the Drift. And I think Lockdown looks really cool. I have no Lockdown figure at this moment. It's not been released yet, so this is all I can have, you know, tie me over. And did I see the arms? Oh my god, there is articulation. Okay, his forearms can move forward. Here, detransform. Alright, so I'm sorry about that, you guys. And a bunch of you guys probably already left comments already, but yeah, his forearms can move upward. Wow, that is not that much articulation, though. And let's put this guy back. Yeah, there. Yeah, damn, it's just frustrating to get this in one piece. I actually wish he transformed like the Drift. Anyway, that's my review, guys. I hope you liked it. Hit the like button if you did. Leave a comment and don't forget to subscribe. And please check out tformers.com for the latest in Transformer news. I'll catch you guys later. Peace.
Put the everyday display, gave it a spark. Welcome to articulated comic book art.
So far as our ticket.